A 19-year-old Florida rapper, Lil Dell, on the run for firing a deadly missile? What? And today we're going to be talking about the Tay K copycat, aka the story of Lil Dell. Now, Lil Dell was a 19-year-old rapper from Florida, more specifically Pensacola, which is the western part of Florida. It's kind of inland, and I'm not gonna beat around the bush, all right? This is one of the top 10 most dangerous small cities in America. It's got a big military base, and besides that, there is fuck all to do there. 27% of kids under the age 18 live below the poverty line. This shit is no joke. Okay, Lil Dell, 19-year-old rapper, doing the grind. He's hustling, right? He's not just one of these delusional whack rappers. He actually sounds good on the microphone. He can harmonize. He's got melodies. I mean, just listen for yourself. I know some niggas sending lows from the hills. I know some niggas coming home on a pill. Tell my bitch I wanna fuck on coming home on a pill. But the problem was, this kid was still 1 foot into whatever street activities he was partaking in. Now, there's no pleasing fans, right? They get mad when the rapper is not doing the stuff that he's talking about in his records, and they also get mad when he is doing the stuff that he's talking about in his records, because they can judge from afar. Now, me, that's not my purpose. My purpose here is just to tell his story. Now, unfortunately, Lil Dell got dragged back into the fuckery. He was a part of a gang called the Bro Gang. Now, I'ma be real. I don't judge an organization based off of their name. They could be super threatening. But I'm not gonna lie, Bro Gang is kind of a whack name. Oh, it's just a gang with the bros. Now, you can make jokes about the name Bro Gang, but locally, these guys were very, very notorious. They were involved in like 20 other shootouts, which, by the way, is no secret, because as we know, in Florida, they pack a toothbrush, they pack a lunchbox to go to school, and they pack a goddamn weapon. And this is the really sad part, is you're not gonna see the success of your rap career if you get caught or brought down for the shit that you're doing outside. Look at Tay K. Tay K got popular off the race, and he also got brought down. It's a double-edged sword. So this kid was 1 foot in, 1 foot out, but he started seeing some success. His song has 100,000 views on YouTube, and he even started making some club appearances. If you start making club appearances in Florida, that's good. That's a good sign. Florida's a vibrant music scene. If you can dominate where you live locally, you can make it on a universal scale. It's just gonna take time. But unfortunately, he didn't give himself that chance. One day, his bros got tipped off that a rival was gonna be at a club called the Platinum Nightclub. Which, by the way, that shit does not look like a nightclub. That looks like an abandoned bingo hall. That's a testament to how trash Pensacola is. I digress. It's no surprise when this kid is talking about going to war and talking in codes on his music, it's no surprise that he actually acts out the shit that he's talking about. So what did they do? They went on a mission. They went to the nightclub. 7 weapons, strapped up, pulled up to the nightclub. It's peak hours. The nightclub, the bingo hall, whatever it is, it's bustling. People are dancing, people are vibing, but Bro Gang shows up and they got a target. They pull out their weapons. We don't even know if they saw the target, but they pulled up right outside in the parking lot and they started blasting. And if you read the headline, I almost got a heart attack. Lil Dell, rapper, fires a deadly missile. That's what I read. I said, what? Tell me they don't have paramilitary weapons in the streets of Florida. And this is why I call Florida Florganistan, right? They call Chicago Chirac. This is the Chronicles of Florganistan. Turns out they shot 44 rounds, but they didn't even hit their target. They shot a poor, innocent woman. God rest her soul. Lil Dell and the Bro Gang, they pull out of the nightclub parking lot and they dip. They leave because the police, they were there in like 4 minutes. They were hot on the trail. They yellow taped off the area. They started taking samples. They looked at the shells. They brought the woman to the hospital. Unfortunately, she didn't make it. Then the police started a strategic manhunt for the Bro Gang, which they broke down quite quickly, except for one person, Lil Dell. Lil Dell managed to evade authorities, and he went on, as Tay K coined it, the race. Now, this man, Lil Dell, was strategic. He left Florida. He went all the way up 5 hours to Austell, which I think is in Georgia, and he was able to hide out for an entire month until finally police tracked him down. You're not gonna do the race and succeed. I mean, police are even using facial recognition. They have these massive databases using your photos from your Facebook page, your Instagram page, even when you go to the bank, stuff like that. They can track you down by matching your face with photos that you put up online. So they ended up finding Lil Dell. They took him in, and the trial starts soon. Now, I'm curious what you guys think, because the blogs are the ones that picked this up and they ran with it because they thought they could recreate the buzz that they got during the whole Tay K situation. But of course, that didn't happen. Not everything is going to be duplicated. Now, I would bring up a study called Moral Judgments Follow the Money. And I think it perfectly explains everybody's role in this situation, from the rapper to the blogs to the audience, right? The audience, they love compelling content. The blogs, they're suppliers. There's a demand. They give what you want. The rapper, he can morally justify what he's doing because he wants to get ahead. And I would caution, don't be on the sidelines and pretend to be all holier than thou and have some type of moral, sanctimonious nature to you that you believe others don't have. And you'd be surprised how quickly your morals can change as soon as your situation changes. But what do I know? Let me know in the comments below what you think. Is there a specific topic you want me to cover? Please smash that like button for me, subscribe with notifications on, and I'll see you in the next video.